I released two books, and the one that is from CCD magazine this year is called Flawed Cadaver, which is the name of one of the pieces in here. And I thought, how perfect that I happen to have a shot of a seal looking at the carcass of a seal from the Galapagos Islands.
Yeah.
And somebody just sent a post up on Facebook saying, you know, the more I look at this, the more I really like that cover for it. Yeah. Like, I'm glad. People think I'm crazy when I'm like, hey.
No, it's usually the ones you saw. Good idea.
So I thought I would read for you. There's one haiku that I'll end this with, but I'm going to do read from the performance art section of this book, which is actually significant for this time of year. This was from a show called Akitu that was in Austin a year ago.
What does Akitu mean?
It's, oh man, I wish you remembered. It's, it's a term for a celebration from older time. Okay. I looked it up and I remembered it then, and other people can look it up. Which I'll have to look it up again because it's been so long. I will.
Celebration, that's enough.
So these are a bunch of things about celebrations for the end of the year.
Good.
And this first one's called Open Flame for the Celebration. Every year as the festival approaches, I would go to the grounds to celebrate. I can still remember riding my roller skates down the streets after the afternoon shower and running my skates through the puddles in the middle of the streets. This was a time for celebrating, and when the big day came, all the families would come together, bring food for the feast. Someone would roast a beast on a spit to spin over an open flame as more and more people would join in the festivities. And I would wear a light dress, skip down the street until it was time to come together to celebrate. And what a celebration it was. And what a celebration it would be. It was the one chance everyone came together to be grateful for our abundance, to honor a higher power, and just to be happy that we all had the chance to be together again.
I like that. That's a really positive one. That's very good.
I think a lot of these are more, well, if you're going to be talking about things for end of the year celebration, they better be.
They better be.
Yes.
Yeah, what's that?
This one is called Every Soul Celebrates.
Yeah.
A poet once described Saturn mythology. Saturn, it says, devours its children.
Mm.
Yes, it's true. I know it. But I never paid attention to that mythology. I love a gas giant planet with moons like our Earth at its creation. A celestial giant with some moons that couldn't quite come together, but formed a nebulous sheet of rings instead. Because even though science isn't mythology, it is truly beautiful. I've always said that. Until I heard of the stories of Saturnalia.
Mm.
When you think of a celebration, you might think of Mardi Gras or the New Year's ball drop in New York City. You might even think of the decadence of Brazil's Carnival. But none of that matches the chance for people to get together from the rich to the slaves and be treated as equals, to celebrate the crops and share the abundance of the year. Because during Saturnalia, this ancient Roman festival honored Saturn as a deity, a god of agriculture, literature, and time. So it only seemed fitting after annual harvest that during this dinner festival, all slaves would be first served, and they would be the masters of the house. This was the time to celebrate prosperity after the crops were good. And because Saturnalia was a holiday, businesses and government offices were closed, so no war was declared on this day.
Mm-hmm.
Roman poets Catullus even called Saturnalia the best of days, and the Augustan poet Horace called this supreme and decadent holiday a December liberty, a leisure free of grievous ambition. And as the end of the year approaches, isn't that what we all look for?
Mm-hmm.
Because we've worked so long, we've accomplished so much, Maybe now we should remind ourselves that sometimes we have to stop and switch things up a bit. Because if Saturn rules agriculture, literature, and time, let's use this time to liberate ourselves and celebrate our fortune in any form with every soul we see.
Yeah.
Yay. You know, you don't expect happy things performance art, but here you go.
Yeah, I'm glad it's happy.
This one is called Endings Bring Light.
Yeah.
Not that you care, but my birthday falls on June 22nd.
June 14th.
The day after the summer solstice.
Ah, yeah.
That means it's just about the longest day of the year, which also means it's the shortest night. But I remember those summer nights near my birthday, savoring dusk at 9 p.m. The days might be long, but they come with a peace that makes you happy to be a part of it. But that's a summer solstice. Flip the year around to right about now and enjoy the long nights. Right before Christmas, this is when everyone, no matter what religion, all gets along. And this December solstice marks the turning of the sun, because after 12:21, the sun is out more and these days only get longer. The ancient Incas held festivals on the day for the sun god on this day because we still celebrate the rebirth of our sun. All I know is that any December solstice celebration translates only to sharing and giving, to loving. And after a long year of struggles and strains, and you think of the year coming to an end, you remember caring, giving, and sharing. It makes it worth celebrating, knowing future days can only lead to more light.
Yes.
This one is titled, Everyone Celebrates Together.
Yeah.
I've always been the one to plan everything, and I know I wanted to celebrate on New Year's Eve. It's weird to think that ancient that this celebration started in 2000 BC in Mesopotamia, Iraq. But even though other cultures use different calendars and celebrate the New Year at different dates, Ethiopians celebrated the rain on September 11th. That Thai New Year, what about that? Well, people splash blessing water on April 13th. The Chinese New Year varies with the lunar calendar, with the lion, dragon, dances, drums, fireworks, and more. And it's all in red for good luck for the next year. Mm-hmm. Some countries celebrate by running into water, freezing cold water. I saw this New Year's polar bear plunge repeatedly, topped with remembering the past and celebrating the new. So, yeah, I usually plan everything. So one December I said, I'm tired of coming up with a plan for New Year's. So I told someone else to come up with a plan. Being a Midwesterner, someone looked at me and said, let's watch the ball drop in New York City. he didn't have a plan of where to stay. He just said it. And my first impulse was to think that this was ludicrous. It's too far away. We have no place to stay. But then I gave it a second thought. Salespeople at my company sell in New York. Maybe I could float the idea their way and maybe we could actually pull this thing off. After I mentioned it to just one saleswoman I've never met in person, they invited me to their home in Connecticut so that we could train into the city with her son and his friends and celebrate New Year. One phone call was all it took. And the next thing I knew is we were road tripping to New York to watch the ball drop in Times Square. And in times like that, in times where we celebrate, everyone is instantly your friend. My coworker brought me to the Chrysler Building so I could see the view from our company's Manhattan offices. And that was the only time I actually photographed the World Trade Center towers, buildings which you never really think of unless the news is bad. But no, this was a time for sightseeing. And you know, people complain about the traffic in New York, but It didn't seem much different from Chicago on this one trip. The roads were my friends, and we all got along just fine. But forget the car on New Year's Eve, my co-worker's son. His name was Trip. And he took me on a trip on a train with new friends into a new town until we found a perfect place for a perfect view on the street. And on this one night, we all screamed together, we all celebrated together, and we all stuck together, even leaning on each other for a nap on the train ride home. Because maybe it's worth it to work on that bucket list, even if you don't have one. Hmm. If the one of the things that comes from an off-the-cuff suggestion to try something you've never tried before, it might amount to meeting tons of new people for moments you'll never forget. And remember, with these celebrations, everyone can celebrate together.
Yes.
And it's so funny, that thing talks about the polar plunge. Just came back
from I'm doing it.
A trip to Antarctica. And I never did the polar plunge in Chicago. I hear that some people in Texas do it, but it's not. It's not the same versus where there's snow everywhere and freezing.
Yeah.
But I never did it, in Wisconsin or in Chicago. I just thought that's kind of silly. And then when I saw that it was an available option to do it at the Southern Ocean when you're close to the South Pole, I'm like, I have to do it.
And you did.
I have to do it.
How cold was it?
It was actually -1 Celsius. It was 30 degrees. The boat that we're from check the water, and people are like, well, why isn't it frozen? I'm like, there's tumultuous water moving and the sun's hitting, and it was fine. And it did not feel that cold.
Oh, why?
Because your brain's thinking everything's going to be weird, and I think I got a little salt water in my mouth, and I'm not used to it. I'm like, salt water weird, just going to get out.
Distracted you from the cold.
I was just like, make sure I can find the things to be able to get out. They put a harness on you in case you totally freak. But no one did.
Put a harness on you when you go over the Sydney Harbour Bridge, and all the harnesses are tied together, so you can't jump off the bridge. Some people have.
Okay.
Like the Golden Gate, some people jump off the Sydney Harbour Bridge.
Yeah. Well.
So.
I haven't done that, so.
No, good. Don't.
I didn't plan to.
One-trick pony.
I didn't plan to. But I'll end on a haiku that was at the end of a story.
Yeah.
That seemed fitting for it. It's called.
Heather, we have your
offer.
Heather, if you'd like to hear this haiku. And it is called Quarrel.
Yeah.
Through choppy waters, quarrel through life's twists and turns, till it's smooth sailing. CCND Magazine.
Those are good.
Brand new issues. And then soon they'll have 2018 issues. So.
Wow.
And so they're going to have Antarctica images on the covers of all of them.
Of course
they will.
We've got so many images. Grand adventure.